Okay, so I'm up at Earthshine tracking the reptiles, and I'm getting a really strong signal on Utsanati, the timber rattlesnake, somewhere over in the power line accessway area that he frequents this time of the year. So let's go find him. Actually, I believe he's closer than that based on the signal I'm getting. This direction. He is not very far at all. Tell you, the field has grown up so much in the last couple of years since they stopped mowing it over here. It's becoming great habitat for all kinds of wildlife. And take a look at this right over here, blackberries, lots of blackberries. See how good they are this year. Well, those aren't ripe yet. No. When they're ripe, they come free easily. Okay. It's excellent habitat for all kinds of wildlife. And you can see deer maybe have been through here. Actually, I would say deer and probably turkeys. Turkeys love this kind of brushy habitat that provides lots of bugs for them to eat and lots of younger, tender young shoots. Utsanati is not that far away. Oh, look at this. Deer tracks and an apple eaten. Oh, possibly bite. No, it looks more like a squirrel there. See how it's got little tooth marks from little incisors, but there's some deer tracks right beside it. So the deer are coming in, eating apples off the lower limbs, and possibly the goats as well. And squirrels are finishing it up for them. Wow, he is very close. Go into attenuator mode. Still very close. Uphill. No, he's not up here. I think he is down. Oop. Where are you, Utsanati? In front of me. Did I just step over him? No. I don't think so. I think he's fooling around with me here. But where is he? Say, oh, there he is. Oh, wow. This is amazing. Utsanati has eaten a squirrel or something. He is so plump. Take a look at this. You go very easy. It's the first time I've been able to observe Utsanati having recently fed. Wow. That's incredible. Hard to see him, but take a look at that. I'm gonna attempt. Get the camera in a little closer. I would say he's eating a squirrel or a rabbit from the size of his distended body. That is beautiful. So hard to see him. All right, I'm gonna put the video down for a minute and take a still shot. Okay, so taking a few pictures of Utsanati and a few pictures of the actual site where he is, the habitat here on the edge of this forest. He's in a classic edge habitat, undoubtedly here because he was feeding on the edge of this forest in this field, and then decided to, of course, sit here in the sun. The sun just recently moved on across the field in that direction because the sun is setting over here to the west behind me, and so he was thermoregulating, most likely. So I'm going to collect his data from this location. He's about 20 feet up the hill. I don't want to be too close to him and potentially disturb him to the point where he regurgitates his meal. That would be terrible. Everything he's gone through to catch and eat whatever it is he has eaten. So I need to do this really quick and just get out of here. Okay, so I'm gonna try to get Utsanati's body temperature if I can. .756, .753, and .753. Last look at him. I just want you to take a look at how incredibly engorged with food Utsanati is. Whatever he ate was huge. Very hard for me to get a good view of him. It's about the best we're going to get. That is one healthy snake. Okay, let's say goodbye to Utsanati. Move down a little farther down the hill here so I'm not disturbing him. See if I can get a better satellite lock. Wasn't able to acquire over at his location. Okay, I think that's the best I'm gonna do. Okay, so Utsanati is resting over there about 40 feet away at the edge of the forest. And he has moved about half a mile since the last time I located him, believe it or not, in June. This has been a really interesting summer for me, so I have not been able to get up here to locate the snakes as often as I would have liked. Circumstances beyond my control kept me away. But it is nice to know that Utsanati is okay and has recently fed on a large rodent of some kind, or possibly a lagomorph, rabbit, in other words. And now it is time to find Jimmy, the box turtle. We're very close because Utsanati is in Jimmy's habitat. This is Jimmy's field. It's where he spends most of his time. So he's very nearby. So let's find him. Take a look at this. It's a Turk's cap or a Carolina lily. I get the two confused. Look how pretty. The beautiful things you see while out walking in the woods. So go take a walk in the forest. Get closer to nature. Let's go find that turtle. Okay, so I've found Jimmy in this area before, but it's been several years. Ow! Darn thorns. Aha! I think I found him. Yeah, he's right here. Okay, you see this little hump of leaves right here? I'm gonna take the camera off of the antenna and show you. And here he is. There's Jimmy. You can see part of his shell. I'm not gonna disturb him. I just wanted to know where he was and what he was doing. So he's up here in the power line access way, up above Utsanati, just down the hill. If you look between the trees there, you can see the lodge. We're really close. But most people never come over here because there's a fence and it's a tangled mass of vegetation. So both of these reptiles are fairly safe. All right, I need to collect Jimmy's data. It's a good place though, take a look. It's open to the sun, so he can thermoregulate if he needs to. And I'm sure when it rains, there's all kinds of slugs and snails, wonderful things that to feed upon here. And he is, like Utsanati, he is right on some healthy edge habitat here. Forest opening, edge habitat. All right. Okay, so Jimmy had moved only about 130 feet from the last location where I found him up on the trail in the woods. And he's in a location where I have seen him before, which, you know, follows around, you know, with Jimmy's routine. Pretty much every year he goes to pretty much the same places as we've discussed in the past. So now let's go find Catherine and Zoe. Not getting a signal for Catherine yet. You know, it's really interesting to think about the rattlesnake Utsanati laying out there in the field after eating a big meal, and the turtle Jimmy bedded down for the night. And right over here, take a look. Earthshine, and the humans are playing. They're having a scavenger hunt, searching for all kinds of interesting artifacts, biological artifacts, natural artifacts, and so on, for fun, for entertainment. They're humans being humans after having a big meal. Just listen. And all the while, nature goes on. The snakes crawl and feed. The turtles move about the mountain. And I go find Catherine and Zoe. All right, so I have a really strong signal for Catherine. And it makes sense because I'm down near Catherine's place, right over here near the barn. Let's just go check out Catherine's place and see if she's there. Okay, she's somewhere up above the neighbor's house. There she is. Right there. Here. There she is. In form, just like Jimmy. Bedded down for the night. I'm not gonna disturb her. I'm just gonna get my data and go on. But I would like to say that it's interesting to see where she is. In this little patch of piney woods, right below Catherine's place, straight up the hill. I've found her in this spot about this time every year for, I would say, about 5 years. Okay, it's time to go find Zoe. Let's see if I can get through this wall of brush. Wow, it's grown up a lot since I was here. About 3 weeks ago. Ouch. Grown up a whole lot. There's some bear scat on the ground. It's pretty old, but a bear's been this way not too long ago. Okay. Well, this is interesting. I've come to the same location that I did a few weeks ago, and Zoe's signal is strongest here. I can't get through this impenetrable wall of thorns, multiflora rose, blackberry, so I'm going to have to collect her data on this location. I'm probably within 50 feet of her though. It seems to be the same old story all summer with Zoe, although there was that one time I did see her. But other than that, she's been rather elusive. So let me get some data collected. All right, so I've located all four reptiles. They're all doing very well. Okay, well, I guess I can't really say Zoe's doing well because I did not see her physically, but she is in an area where that she has frequented over the last 3 years that I've been tracking her. The turtles and Utsanati are doing great. Both of them were following their normal turtle routine. And Utsanati the rattlesnake, as you saw, fat and happy, full of a tasty rodent or rabbit meal. And me, I'm going to the beach. That's right. Time for a vacation from snake and turtle tracking. And just gonna go to the beach and take it easy for a while and look for dolphins and snakes and turtles. You know, I can't not look for reptiles. It's me, it's what I do. So join me out there somewhere.